disappearing into the mountains. Just 2 days after this event, government officials secretly gathered a team of scientists for a curious assignment. They were to investigate the crash of an unidentified flying object on the outskirts of Kingman, Arizona, a city 175 miles south of the nuclear test site.
There were 40 engineers that boarded a bus, and they took a long 3.5 hour ride from Phoenix to Kingman. When they got there, it was nighttime. There were MPs on all corners of the craft. It's about a 40-foot diameter dish-shaped craft that was perfectly intact. There wasn't a scratch on it. There were four beings associated with this craft, and they shipped it to Groom Lake.
Groom Lake is the Area 51 region in Nevada. When Area 51 was just bare bones, they took the craft and the aliens back to that location in the middle of the Nevada desert because it was so remote. And around there, they built Area 51.
Hidden within a ring of mountains deep in the Nevada desert, Area 51 is a top-secret military installation that has long been rumored to hold evidence of alien technology. And there are even stories that a special facility at Area 51 once held a survivor of the 1953 Kingman UFO crash. An alien entity known as J-Rod.
J-Rod is an alien who allegedly worked at Area 51 over a period of years, and it was J-Rod's mission or duty to help reverse engineer technology that was apparently from the 1953 Kingman UFO crash. J-Rod was one of the crash survivors and worked directly with our own government.
Air Force performing experimental testing on aircraft was assigned to Area 51 in the mid-1960s, and he claims that he not only studied the craft that allegedly crashed in Kingman, Arizona, but also had direct contact with J-Rod.
We had a long period of introduction into meeting, and I called him J-Rod. That's the name that the linguist gave him. And he would talk, but he'd sound just like if you spoke, he'd sound like you. Really, he's like one of the parrot. But he'd try and answer your question. Basically, it was only engineering advice or science advice.
There's also another whistleblower by the name of Dan Gurish. And Dan Gurish said that he was hired as a microbiologist to basically care for J-Rod, ensuring that he remained healthy. And this went on for years and years and years.
According to Dan Burich and Bill Uhouse, J-Rod was housed in a special underground chamber at Area 51. And there have been numerous other accounts of extraterrestrials working with the United States government.
There's a lot of stories that we've worked with the aliens at Area 51. Some say at a base nearby, kind of in the desert out there. And we've been working with them in the underground labs, and they have been sharing information for us to enhance our technologies.
Is it possible that the United States government has met with and worked with entities like J-Rod and other alien visitors since at least the 1950s? UFO researchers, there is evidence that extraterrestrials have not only been held at secret military bases, but have even met face-to-face with the commander-in-chief inside the walls of the Pentagon. One of the most detailed accounts of a presidential close encounter is the story of an otherworldly visitor named Valiant Thor.
The story of Valiant Thor comes from a gentleman by the name of Frank Stranges, who's a chaplain and